Hello and welcome to Hamara Kal. Well, it's back.
There we go. We were wondering what Bajaj's first electric scooter would be called, and it is plenty clear now.
It is the Chetak, not the electric Chetak or the Urbanite or anything like that. It is the Bajaj Chetak, and it's back. And well, as an electric scooter should be for today's day and age, this thing looks, well, classical and futuristic all at the same time. As you can see, this one here, which is in this grey matte finish color, really well finished. And well, if you're talking about design elements, you can see here with the seat, there's also the contrast red stitching for the seat. Really slick, but that's only some of the more smaller details. There's more to talk about it, which gives it that cool quotient. And wait, we gotta show you the face, right? There you go. This surround for the headlamp here is actually like a LED DRL. We don't have the keys to these bikes, and there's a very interesting thing about that as well. We'll talk about that later. And the headlamp is also LED, and you can see it down there. And of course, the turn indicators are LEDs. And well, there's, in terms of tech, it's got some really cool tech. We'll talk about that. But first, the design. This looks like quite a sizable scooter, big scooter. And you can see the seat is nice and long. Practicality wise, you've got the flat floorboard. And well, that covers all the scooter points, which would be about practicality, right? But Bajaj insists that this is about creating a premium experience. So you'll see things like a digital display, right? Which isn't switched on, but it's a really cool looking thing. And you can see like how they've done the Chetak C here as a design element. There's no Bajaj to be seen on this, or Urbanite. And now start looking around. Do you see a key slot? No, you don't. That's because it's keyless. You just have the key fob in your pocket, and you can switch it on and just look at these switches. Piano black switches, look and feel just so nice and premium. This looks really slick. And of course, notice the design for the rear view mirrors as well. Nicely finished. This feel like metal, but I think it's plastic, but it's really nice and sturdy. Design is handsome. And yeah, you see the M button here. Now we're getting to the powertrain, because that's the M button for the modes. You've got an eco and a sport mode. In eco mode, it can go 95 kilometers on a charge. On sport mode, it'll do 85 kilometers, and you can charge this off any 15 amp plug at home. The batteries will be somewhere in there, but we can't open that right now. But we do know that the batteries are not swappable. The idea is that the person using these scooters would be doing about 20-25 kilometers a day. So yeah, in terms of usability, you've got more than enough for somebody planning to use this every day. The batteries are rated for IP67, which basically means it's waterproof, so you don't need to worry about that. And yeah, so this is the basic layout, and here I'm going to show you, like, it also has this closed glove box. And Bajaj have said that this is meant to be a premium experience, and I'll give you an example of that. You hear that? It's nicely damped here and there. There's no crack. It's just gently opening and closing softly. So small details like that. And of course, in terms of design, you will see that the front suspension is single-sided. You can look at the alloy wheels there, pretty cool. And the same applies for the rear as well. So the motor is sitting right there next to the wheel there, not somewhere inboard. I'll show that to you from this side. Yeah, that's where the battery's at, driving the rear wheel directly. And you've got, it seems like a drum brake here. Might be variants here of the Chetak, but we don't have clarity on that, because this hasn't been launched here today. This has just been an unveil of the Chetak. It will be launched in January. Deliveries will start in January, starting from the city of Pune, the hometown of Bajaj, with then the sales expanding to Bangalore. And it is going to be retailed from Bajaj's pro biking showrooms, from where you get KTMs and KTMs, and plan is to have Husqvarnas there as well. But the Chetak will also be there, because Bajaj believe that this is more of a, you know, a heart statement, a heart product. And I completely buy that, because this thing looks and feels good, but should deliver practicality. In terms of price, we don't have the price right now, but Bajaj say that it will be attractive. So yeah, these are the colors on display here. You've got this gray, the maroon, there's a blue out there, and the black. Aside from this, there's a white and also a golden. So six colors in all for the Chetak, which will be in showrooms starting January 2020. Quite nice looking from the rear as well, I gotta say. Looking forward to riding this. And yes, the Chetak is already on roads because there's been a Chetak electric yatra that started off from Delhi today and is going to be riding down all the way to Pune and might even head down to Goa. So if you catch it somewhere in the way, do tag us and let us know if you spot them. Thank you for watching ZigWheels. More details on the Chetak a little later.